this shit! This episode of Triple CHS is brought to you by DraftKings.com. What's up, fight fans? I'm the Lakers Rocket Scuffle of Mixed Martial Arts, Tommy Toehold. And UFC 230 should be one of the cursed objects in the basement in the cabin in the woods. Right after they finally released an official poster for the Madison Square Garden card featuring Luke Rockhold, Luke Rockhold fell down an elevator shaft or some shit, and the co-main event with Chris Weidman is off. Jacare, who was set to fight David Branch, is now fighting Weidman, and Branch will now fight Jared Cannonier, who was set to take on Alessio De Chirico November 17th. Fuck you, Alessio De Chirico. UFC 230 has taken more hits than Nick and Nate's bongs. Diaz Poirier was canceled, Romero Costa was canceled, Keller Pilarte was canceled, and of course the main event, which never was, but actually was for a moment, Shevchenko versus Eubanks was canceled.
Fuck you, Tommy! This card is my Godfather Part 1 and 2! Fuck your Saturdays! Fuck your entertainment!
Injury bug, you giant piece of shit. You may have damaged this one, but we're still getting some pretty damn good fights. All right, the main event's for the heavyweight title and is solid, and the co-main event is still just as compelling.
That's what you think, motherfucker. Wait until next week. I'm gonna fuck up so much of UFC 230, they're gonna change the venue to a high school gymnasium just to get a capacity crowd.
You are the fucking worst, injury bug. Chris Weidman, how does it feel to fight Jacare on 2 weeks' notice after finally breaking your bad luck streak in New York against Gastelum?
Bad luck is superstition. Superstition's fucking super stupid. You either punch a fucking hole through somebody's chest or you fucking don't. Don't matter what fucking shorts you're wearing, how many fucking times you tapped your gloves before you walked out. You fucking idiots. Stop believing in stupid shit.
Hey, I'm going from fighting an absolute killer to fighting an absolute killer. There are no fun fights at the top of the division, you just gotta do it. Join the team, you guys.
What are you trying to say? That we're afraid to fight Jacare on short notice? Is that what you're trying to say? Is this something we're supposed to be scared of? Is this something we're supposed to be afraid of him? Was Jacare the fucking boogeyman? Was he Michael Myers, Freddy Krueger, Jason? What is he? No, I'm not saying you're supposed to be scared. I was just wondering if it sucked having to change your opponent this close to fight night.
That's a stupid fucking question.
Yeah, what do you mean does that suck? That's like asking, does it suck to have your fucking balls bit by a rabid deer? Of course it fucking sucks. What, you think we want to change our opponent a few weeks before the fight? You think we're fucking hoping and praying that 2 days before the fight the fucking opponent's gonna change again or something? Of course nobody likes that, but it's a fucking fight business. We train for everything, we prepare for everything. What a stupid fucking question.
I fucking hate you, Tommy Toehold.
Let me tell you something right now. Don't come to Long Island, Tommy. You will not like what happens, okay? You come to Long Island, it's gonna be problems, motherfucker.
Chest hole punching, that's what's gonna fucking happen.
Thanks for coming on the show, guys, and Chris, best of luck in a few weeks.
Thanks, Tommy. I'm gonna beat Jacare and finally get that title shot I deserve. If the middleweight title even still exists, feels like after Bisbee beat Rockhold, it's been another dimension. Join the team now, guys, because the team's gonna be full after UFC 230.
That's the show, fight fans! We finally got that Eagle Bear Smash gear you've been asking for at the Rear Naked Cloak Shop. Go get it right now. The link is in the description. Fuck yeah! Next episode, we're talking to Eddie Alvarez about heading to 1FC Championship or whatever the fuck it's called now. See you tomorrow, fight fans!